Well, as the voice of Chicago, Peter Cetera recorded hit after hit and he dominated the charts as a solo artist. The singer-songwriter is in the country for a series of very special shows and we'll chat with him in a moment. But first, let's remember where it all began. How can you not sing along to those songs? Let's welcome in Mr. DJ and Peter Cetera, everyone!
Hello, how are you?
Oh, wow!
Wow, look,
you're
at me.
A rock star.
You smell good too.
You have sunglasses. Sunglasses on, you have to be a rock star.
What are you wearing?
Yeah,
is that too forward?
No, I think it's Tom Ford something.
Oh, it's very nice.
Wow. And you know, it is nice, isn't it?
It's great.
Yeah, it's fabulous stuff.
You smell good, you sound good.
No. Yeah. Well, thank you. Thank you. Yes, I smell good and sound good.
And you're wearing sunglasses, which is the hallmark of a rock star. Well, that's how we can tell you.
Especially at 10:30, 11 in the morning.
Yeah. Would you normally be up at this hour?
I'd be up, but I wouldn't be in front of cameras. And, you know, one's face doesn't wake up until noon, 1 o'clock. You know.
Yeah, I find my brain doesn't wake up until even after that.
So. Yeah.
Now, you certainly know your way around a power ballad. Belting out those songs, I mean, wow, we all were belting them out with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've had a lot of success both with Chicago and with my solo career with ballads. I mean, people think that that's the only thing I've sang and write, but I mean, I think if you listen to most of the CDs, there's only one or two songs on there that are ballads, but people tend to really like the way I do them.
So. You're the king of the power ballad, aren't you?
I am? Better than being the queen.
You played the bass with Chicago, but you started off playing the accordion, didn't you? Why did you change instruments?
I
think it's obvious, isn't it?
I know lots of people love the accordion.
Is that that one?
Yeah,
with the squeeze box. I tried to get a guitar. My parents wouldn't allow it. So you're looking at probably the last boy from Chicago that was forced to play the accordion. there are some very famous accordion players.
Yeah.
And I was thinking one time about doing an album with the sign for don't with the slash through it. Play an accordion, go to jail. You know, Weird Al Yankovic.
Yeah.
Caitlyn Jenner.
Really? Yeah. Well, she plays
not anymore, I don't think, but, you know, with the bellow shaking, but, yeah.
You probably pick up more chicks with the guitar, don't you think?
Accordion. Yeah, I think so.
Speaking from experience, are you there?
Yeah, no.
You mentioned Chicago, of course, and
you mentioned Chicago.
No, we did, yes.
Oh, well,
we mentioned it a lot.
But I mean, the songs, then of course your solo career as well. What was the motivation for you to go solo?
Well, you know, being in a band is like being married. At a certain point, you know, little things start
to niggle,
and then this and. We got to a point where they wanted me to leave and I wanted me to leave. And
what were the things that were niggling? What were the...
Oh, you know, it's... music is funny. It's it gets to be ego and it gets to be jealousy and it gets...
But why did they want you to leave?
Well, because they wanted to have certain restrictions on... You know, the thing is, back in the day with Chicago, when you first started doing videos, the person that sang the lead was the lead in the video.
Yeah.
And that created quite a bit of attention.
So was that a restriction? They wanted you to be in the back room singing?
Sort of, yeah.
But you're the lead singer. What part of the lead singer don't they understand?
That was my point.
And your hair's so fantastic.
Oh,
just, how could you possibly be, like, singing in the back?
I don't know. But anyhow, yeah, it created a little bit of a friction.
Mm.
And then musically, we just sort of parted ways. And it's like a marriage. You know, people say, would you ever get back together? And it's sort of like, would you ever get back together with your ex-husband or your ex-wife?
Mm. So never? Mm. There'll never be a reunion?
Oh, we never say never, but I don't think so. And
do you
know,
talk still or not?
I talk to one of them occasionally, Robert Lamb.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's kind of like your songs are like the children, you know. You stay together for the children, basically. Yeah. And then at a certain point, when the children are on their own, then you...
And you share custody.
Yeah, no, you don't. And I've had so much more fun as a solo artist.
And tell us about the shows you're doing with the orchestra. That sounds exciting.
Well, I got a call years ago. I put together, right when I went solo, and Glory of Love came out, and it was number one, and then I had Next Time I Fall with Amy Grant came out. I put together a seven-piece electric group, and without not much help from the record company, and I sort of went, well, there's no room in the music business for me, and I sort of went up to Idaho, where I still live, and kind of hid out. And then my friend David Foster...
But you're going to perform here with the Sydney Symphony. Now, that's a big... That's a big band.
Right. Well, what's happened was I got a call from PBS, wanted to know if I would do a special with the symphony. So I did put it together, and it became enormously successful. Mm. So I went and did a succession of symphony shows.
Right.
And then in the meantime, I put together a seven-piece group, and been doing that now for 15, 20 years with the group, occasionally doing symphonies. The Sydney Symphony came up with this lovely offer, and I had a chance to come back here. So Friday night, the one show Friday, two shows on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
With the Sydney Symphony and my five-piece unplugged group, the Bad Daddies.
What a Bad Daddies!
No, it's, you know, the Bad Daddies. We were all rehearsing.
Wow, that's great.
You know, in a studio a while back, and a lot of us had our children running around, you know, eating donuts, and we were the
literally bad daddies.
Such bad daddies, yeah.
Well, we have a fantastic CD here as well, an album you've just released. It's brilliant. All the dates on where you can see Peter are also on our website. Thanks so much for coming.